Okay, I'm going to lay a piece of strap iron across the top of my sawhorses, and that's just going to be for extra protection. And I've got holes drilled every so often, and I countersink them with a bigger bit, and I'm about to do that on the drill press. Okay, I got one screw in. I got these blocks clamped here so I don't create a lip for my brackets. These screws are stainless steel. It's what I had laying around from the hog shed. All right, got that job finished. Got my strap iron on the backs of my sawhorses. Okay, got this sawhorse put together. And they come all the way down to here to the splay in the legs. And this is how I brace this splay. I've drilled the holes in here, put a washer in there. Washer in there, and I cut this piece of galvanized pipe to fit in here. And run all thread all the way through it. Got it bolted down. And I'll show you how I measured for this. Okay, to lay out for my braces here on the bottom of the feet, just come up 4 inches. Marked it. Have my bevel set at 10 degrees. Strike your lines. And I'll continue this line all over to the other side, mark both places. To drill the hole on the outside, I have to put the leg in the other way. I just put this inch board on my wedge, then put my leg on top of the board, and that pretty well lines that. That bit just will go straight down, right in line. I have a 1/4 inch drill bit in my hand drill. Now that I got a hole as a guide, that should come out right smack dab on the other side, right on target. I start out with 1/4 inch and I'll work my way up to 3/8. I'll just keep stepping up. Let's see if that hole is... right on the money. I stick my washers in there. Like I said, I'm going to have washers in here to keep that pipe from just digging into the wood. Okay, I have these two sticks and I'll use them as a gauge. I just spread them apart, take my pencil, make a mark. Run those sticks out to this mark. I'll clamp it, then measure the sticks, and I'll come out with 8 inches plus 1/8. So 8 1/8 inches. That's what I cut my pipe to. Okay, I took my tape measure, measured out 8 1/8 inches, marked it, got my pipe cutters on it. So here we go. Alright, the next step is to cut dados for drawers that'll be under the bench top. And these are 8 inches. And I think that'll be alright. So here I measured 1.5 inches in the center of the drawers. Mark the bottom one right here. Leave plenty of space in between so things can stick up, you know, and have plenty of clearance. So the next step is to mark these on all the legs. So what I've done is put both sawhorses on my workbench top. That's flat. So where this bottom of the dado is, on the bottom drawers, is about 6.5 inches. So I cut the gauge block. Just put it up against the leg and mark them on both sides. Now to mark the bottom of the dados in the top drawer, cut another gauge board, squared it up. Of course, you mark where you want the dado to be on top of that line. And I think that'll pretty well get them straight and even.